YOLOv5 introduces retina mask that outputs stunning and crisp segmentations at 140 FPS while still being deployable to edge devices. Hey there, welcome to LearnOpenCV. In this video, we will see how to segment objects using YOLOv5. Ultralytics released segmentation models with the YOLOv5 7.0 release. The models take an input image and outputs image with mask that accurately localize the object. As the model size increases, YOLOv5 outputs better masks and recognizes the objects better. These masks, however, look blurry. If you change the model from nano to extra large, it segments more objects, but the masks remain blurry. Retina mask flag, however, upscales the segmentation output to native resolution, making the mask edges more defined. Let's see YOLOv5 segmentation in action. We'll be segmenting the objects in these four images. Let's head to the notebook and download and unzip these images. We use these two functions to download and unzip the images. And then, to run inference, we need the YOLOv5 repository. Let's clone the repository. Next, let's install the requirements. Inside the YOLOv5 directory, under segment, we'll be running the predict.py script to run inference on our images. Execute the predict.py script and pass the weights to the YOLOv5 model, the source image directory, and the directory to store results in. The exist OK flag specifies that if the result directory does exist, do not create a new directory. The code cell outputs a lot of things. It outputs the inference options, for example, the input image size, various thresholds, and more. It also prints the system configuration. We are using YOLOv5 version 7.something, Python 3.8, PyTorch version, and the GPU that we are using. Then it downloads the models and finally saves the results in this folder. And once the inference is complete, results are stored in this directory. The function visualize is used to display all the images inside a directory using matplotlib. We input the results directory and it plots all the images in that directory. As you can see, the object masks are blurry and the edges are not clean. We tried the nano model for these outputs. Let's try using the extra large model instead. We use the same command, but this time we change the weights. Although it did segment more objects than the nano model, the largest model did not improve the mask quality. This is because YOLOv5 outputs the seg mask over downsampled images. So, if we upsample the mask to native resolution, we get better results. The retina mask flag does just that. Let's run the same code, but with retina mask option as well. As you can see, the results look objectively better than before.
Let's see YOLOv5 segmentation in action. As you can see, the results look objectively better than before. This improvement, though, does come with a disadvantage. A 92 FPS segmentation output quickly decreases to 67 FPS with Retina mask on a laptop GTX 1650 with CUDA 11.7. We have access to 5 YOLOv5 segmentation models, nano model being the smallest with just 2 million parameters and extra large being the largest with 88.8 million parameters. As the model size increases, the MAP for box and mask both increase. Meanwhile, the inference time also increases. It is a common trend for deep learning models to run slower when the number of parameters increase. YOLOv5 models also outperform other state-of-the-art segmentation models like sparse instance segmentation or solo V2 models. It clips the segmentation mask to the corresponding bounding box.
This ensures that the mask does not overflow out of the bounding boxes and also run faster. The YOLOv5 segmentation models are created by adding protonet to the object detection head. Protonets are FCNs used for semantic segmentation that outputs prototype masks. All the three branches of protonet work similarly but on different feature map dimension. The model will input images in the shape batch size, number of channels, height and width, and output results in the shape 1, 25,200 and 117. We need to apply NMS on this output to get the desired results. This modified head produces 117 outputs per anchor, out of which the detection head solely outputs 80 class labels, 4 bounding box coordinates and 1 confidence score. In addition, we also get 32 mask outputs. That totals to 117 outputs per anchor. So, 117 cross 3 and we get total 351 output channels. The input channels increase as we go from nano to extra large model. For example, there are 64 input channels in the nano model, whereas there are 320 input channels in the extra large model. But finally, the output channels from all the models are always constant. 32. We get 32 masks. So, that's all about segmentation using YOLOv5. If you like this video, check out our YOLO Masterclass playlist on YouTube, where we understand the workings of other YOLO models. Do comment on what you would like to see next and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Until next time.